Hello and welcome back. This is Double O Debbie and this is episode 45 of Agrarian's Guys 2. Today's episode is going to take us deep into the nether. No, not really. today, I just wanted to come in here and we need to fill our wands up, and I need to find a better way to fill up our wands. whoa! Hello! Well, I don't know exactly... Oh! I need to turn that back on. I don't know exactly what they did in some of the updates, but apparently they fixed the mob spawning in the nether. Oh, hello. yeah, because look at... There used to be, like, nothing in here. Now there's just mobs everywhere. But, you know, that's cool. We're ready for it. It was kind of nice having a little peaceful nether to come into to start, but I'm glad they got it fixed, so that's super cool. Super cool and awesome. Yeah, I kind of ran these guys a little dry. I was having some fun decorating the infusion altar, and I used up a little bit of stuff. And, oh, I found the quest that that we need to do in the Thaumcraft section, because it gives... Oh, a Silverwood sapling. Whoa, whoa. Hello? Not supposed to be dying here. Huh. Whoops, I guess I should pay attention to that life thing over there. I don't know what it is, but I seem to run faster in the nether than... in the overworld. I don't know. Maybe there's just more land to run on. It could be. I don't know. There we go. Hey, dude. Awesome. Yeah, so... tons and tons of aspects that we need still. This is usually what I do to fill up my wands. Usually it doesn't take this long because there's tons of mobs, but maybe I've just cleared them out and... Whoa, whoa, whoa! Hello, tougher than normal zombie pig. That was a warped guy. Alright, maybe we should kill some wisp. Hey, come here. Oh, bat. We must be full on something. Thank you, Mr. Wisp, for coming down here so I can kill you. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Come on, little guys, don't be shy. There's so many oh! Yipes! Those guys explode. They explode. Shh. Okay, we got this one full. Except for air. And this one looks full, so... maybe we'll kill one more group of pigmen here. The guys with the things on their head are tougher too. Whoa, whoa! No smacking! No smacking of the Debbie, please. Okay, that should be good. That should be good. Let's get back over here and see what we can do today. I looked at the recipe for that we need to make, and it doesn't look too bad. Doesn't look too bad at all. Ooh. It's always a little bit of laggy. A little bit laggy when you first come back in from the nether because everything's got to reload. And we can just throw some of this stuff in here. I also want to make some candles for our infusion altar. That can just get thrown overboard. Soak in that. Let's see what's in the treasure bag, though. I really need to automate that where it'll turn the gold coin. That's all we got was gold coins. It's horrible. Let's throw these swords away. Okay, wrong platform. Up one. There we go. Yeah, look. That is, I like how the stones look. They look pretty cool. I will be using that later. It's just in case you were wondering what the heck I wanted to do with zombie flesh and string. There. That ought to clean up our inventory a little bit. Just a little bit. Had to break out the old gold banded wand just to finish up some of the crafting I wanted to do earlier. I guess I should have taken that with me, but oh well. Not gonna do it now. I scanned a few of these things because I'd forgotten to. So, yeah. Anyway, let me show you the quest that I was talking about. The alchemical smelting. Look what we get. Silverwood sapling. That means I won't have to bother with pecs or actually doing the complicated, super difficult ritual. We can just get one and then get it to growing and be happy. We just need to make this alchemical furnace, which I was gonna make anyway, so it's super double awesome. And this thing isn't too bad looking. I think we might even have all the stuff. Some arcane stone blocks. Hopefully I didn't turn all of them into. Oh, good, good. We didn't turn all of them into the bricks. Okay, and we need a crucible and a furnace. That doesn't sound too bad at all, does it? And I know we can get a furnace just like this. There we go. And we have iron over here, I believe. So we just need to make a cauldron. Throw that bad boy down and whack it with our wand. And then we're ready to make the alchemical furnace. Just like this. I don't know what the vis cost is. Not too bad. 4.5. That's with our 10% discount, woot! So that would normally cost 5 water, 5 fire, alchemical furnace. Oh yeah. And we get an order crystal cluster. So that's pretty cool. Let's see. Where would we want to put that? I like them from the ceiling. I know they don't give off any light or anything, but I think they look really cool. I remember one of the things that I miss about the old Thaumcraft was that you could actually grow the crystals. I thought that was cool. Or you would take, like, you would get one of the clusters and then it would shoot off little little crystals off the side, and you would have to take a little, crystal hammer and come over and whack on them, break off the little crystals. It was pretty cool. They need to do that again. Do that again. That was cool. So, awesome. We got a Silverwood sapling. We're halfway to completing this quest now, and that'll get us a note in a jar. I think, we have a note in a jar, but this could be a special note in a jar. I don't know. Do you take the note in the jar or the reward bag? Oh. So, one thing I do know about these Silverwood saplings is that you cannot really bone mill them. So that kind of stinks. We need to just. I don't know if this stuff is going to get in the way over here. Let me just break it. I can always put it back later. We have tons of these little pink leaves, the sakura leaves. So, no biggie. See, I still have 49 stacks. So we'll just let that thing grow. Hopefully it'll grow soon and we can chop it down, get some more saplings, hopefully. Yeah. Excuse me, I just need to get a little drink of water. Awesome. Also, I think I'm getting a little sick here. Before we can do any of these rituals, on the infusion altar, we need liquid vis, in the warded jars around it before, because it's got to have the vis from somewhere, so I don't know. We have to make those warded jars so we can, and get the little alchemical thing set up so that we can actually break the stuff down into this. Sorry, just a little adjusting of the position. I put a little clip about this on the end of the last episode, but after the last episode, I don't know, I got the first little bit of warp that I've seen. It didn't do anything negative, it just gave me a little bit of ordo, I saw, and since then, my bees have been, I don't know, they've been really producing tons and tons of stuff. I don't know if it was temporary or what, but oh man, they produced so many things that it was all backed up, so I went and made three more centrifuges. And look at that, it's all backed up. Oh man. What? I think this is because I have this paper one in here from the knowledge one. So it's still, oh my God, so many so many things in this. Go ahead and craft all that other stuff up. Yeah, they're producing like crazy. How about these guys? I'm gonna throw these all in there. There we go. That might help clear it up. But I have these doing the propolis and these doing just the combs. I also set up a little auto crafting area down here, so that any of the little dust particles that come in get auto-crafted into the air, the respective shards. So I just took all of the shards over and look at that. Before this episode started, I emptied this thing out, and I mean, it's still processing things probably that were in there before that, but I wonder how many knowledge fragments. Oh my goodness. There was nothing in there when I started this episode. Nothing. They're just going crazy. I don't know what's going on, but I'm not going to complain. Definitely not going to complain about it. So we got tons and tons of aspects. I did make one more bee for the savant. Have one here and one here. And these guys need desert emulation upgrades. Just because of the savant thing. But that's no big deal. So, yeah. Just tons of stuff for us. Like I said, I didn't do anything. I don't know what's going on. They're just producing so many things. Oh my goodness. It's crazy. So yeah, I doubled the centrifuges. I think I might add another little setup like this on this wall. Add two more centrifuges to help break down the combs. Maybe just have two combs per machine, and then one just for the papery combs. Since we have two of those bees, we're getting twice as much of those combs. And that just, I think that just makes us paper. We should have tons of paper in here. Well, I guess not. Anyway, super cool and awesome things are happening, and I'm happy. It grew already! Look at it! It's beautiful! Oh my goodness. I don't know. I don't want to chop it down. I don't want to chop it down. What if I don't get another sapling? Oh. Let's get our little scanner mabob out here. Well, that's just awesome. We'll be able to make silverwood wands. I don't see like a node or anything in there. Awesome! I was not expecting it to grow so quickly. But that is awesome. So, we need to chop down this tree and hope we get another sapling. Maybe even an extra. But one thing I have learned about Thaumcraft, these silverwood trees, is that you do not want to break the leaves, the leaf blocks. Just let them decay. Don't even break them with your hand. Oh, it went into... Oh, it destroyed my platform! That is, I really like how they changed how the silverwood trees look and made them 2x2s instead of just one wide. They look really cool. I like it. So, super cool and awesome. Silverwood! Oh yeah! Yeah, we really should, I'll probably try and, make up a whole bunch of those warded jars. Destroyed my bricks. Okay, it's okay. I guess I'll have to live with it. You know, I don't know where I'm gonna get any more bricks. just no idea where I will find 4 more bricks. I think that's a good trade-off, right? How am I gonna get up there? Let's just tower up. It's really hard to break things when you're flying. Get that. Oh no, I broke one! That's horrible. That could have been a sapling. Alright. I really like the design of this tree. It looks super cool and awesome. Awesome. Okay, now we have to wait and see if we get a sapling. It's already starting to decay. It would really be nice to get an extra sapling from this. I know, I've tried it in the past and I've broke every, you know, leaf. Even if you have fortune or anything, it doesn't work. You just gotta let it decay. So, I'm afraid something's gonna fall over the edge. I should have probably put it more towards the middle. Come on! Give me a sapling! Give me a sapling. No sapling? Really? No sapling. I like how the... Oh! We got one! That is awesome. We got a sapling! We got a sapling. Now we just need one more. Come on, sapling! Come on. You can do it. You can do it. Okay, so I was really worried that we wouldn't get at least one to make another tree. But now that we have that one, maybe we could do something other than staring up waiting for a sapling to drop. I'm just afraid that it's gonna fall over the edge. If I'm not here. No, it's pretty far away from the edge. I think it'll be okay. I need to look. Let's just, while we're over here, let's look and see if we have the recipe. I think we should have the recipe for the jars. That's the node in the jar. Would that be under artifice, I bet. No. No, I don't know. Maybe it's in this one. Just node in a jar. Let's see if jar. What a jar. Okay, it looks like it's a basic recipe and we don't need to research anything. Just some glass panes, a slab, and it takes an aqua. Which we should have plenty of now. So, oh, it's not going to give another sapling. Come on. Please, just one more. Just one more. Come on. Come on. Anyway, we'll let that go. Oh, I was really hoping to get that other quest done, but I'm happy we got a sapling. We got a silverwood sapling. We got some silverwood logs now. They look super cool and awesome when you look at that. Look at how awesome that looks. Isn't it beautiful? Oh yeah. It's a butterfly! Come here, butterfly! Oh my goodness, they're so beautiful. They should call them beautiflies. Come back, come back! Oh my goodness, I love that. I love the butterflies. Oh, butterflies. They're so cute. Sorry. I can't help it. They're cute. They're cute. What else I doing? Yeah, okay. Ordered jars. Let's get some glass. Glass. Ooh, we don't have that much. Oh my goodness. I bet we have, I wonder how much sand we have now. 22,000! Oh my goodness. That is awesome. So, I wouldn't feel bad at all about just auto smelting up some glass in there. So, we're gonna need some, let's put this stuff in here. So, I want to replant this since we didn't get our second sapling. Oh, sapling. Let's come over here. I swear, I'm going to do something productive. I know I am. Okay. Get that little guy there. Please, sapling. No. Well, I guess I'm happy that we at least got one sapling out of that to replant. That's always a big risk when you're dealing with those trees, is not getting a sapling to replant. Okay, so we need those, and now we need some slabs. I wonder if we have any made up. We do! That is super cool and awesome, because I'm pretty sure we don't have 64 combines worth of jars. And yes, you will need all of these guys. 0.9. Yeah, we should be able to get all of these out of there. Oh yeah, 22 jars. And we're probably also gonna need some help. Oh, look. I can fix this. Oh, it's lagging. Oh my goodness. What am I gonna do? It's daytime. It's daytime. It's lagging. It's raining. What? Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. Alright. Now that we have sunshine instead of rain, we can place our little jars up here. They just have to be close to it. Wonder if I can... Now see, this is the dilemma. Do I go up one? Beep, 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 on top of it, or back one? Do I wrap around? I don't know. Maybe do... Because the golems are... If we have golems help us, which we'll probably want, because that gets tedious doing the jars, in the little vials and manually doing it. So if we're gonna have golems, then we'll definitely want to make sure they're connected. No, I don't like it when they're... maybe we'll just run them one row behind the other. I like the sound of that. Doink! 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 Sorry. Silliness. Warning. Silliness. Overload. Awesome. I like it. Yeah. Okay. So now we have to figure out how to break down our materials, which means we're going to need some of these... Probably in the alchemy section, yeah. These Essentia Distillation. There was our alchemical furnace that we made, and we got our super cool sapling from. I knew there was a quest in there that would give us that gave a sapling. I just couldn't find it, and yeah. So now we have a sapling. We have silverwood, so we can make these easy peasy. But there is I believe the X-Astris recipes where if you can't get these, you can still make it. I think it's like, let's look. This filter from the sky. Yeah, it takes a lot of silk mesh, but you can do it without silverwood. So that's cool. Super cool and awesome. And yeah, we did use this to just conserve on our vis. One less trip to the nether. We have those nodes. Once we, you know, progress up in Thaumcraft, hopefully we'll be able to use those nodes that we acquired from a bag and from quest rewards to recharge our wands instead of having to run to the nether all the time. So that would be cool. And I'm glad we didn't have to do that complicated ritual for the silverwood, since we can't make these blooms and it costs so many things. But we're getting ready. Okay, so how many of these little guys are we going to need for a setup? I forget. So we're going to need these arcane alembics and alchemical that's to sort of help automate it, I think. Let's read it. In the future, you will definitely need to have ready access to multiple different kinds of aspects, not just primal aspects drawn from your wand. Using basic alchemical principles, you've devised a way to break down objects and convert them into essentia. The first step in this process requires an alchemical furnace. The alchemical furnace works much like a normal furnace by burning coal to produce heat. But instead of smelting ore into metal, it breaks down objects into a slurry of raw, unprocessed essentia. The next step in the process is to take the essentia slurry and distill it using an arcane alembic. To work, arcane alembics need to be placed on top of an alchemical furnace. The essentia slurry will slowly be drawn into the alembic, and the individual aspected essentia separated out. If the alchemical furnace is being powered by alumentum, this distillation process is much faster. That's cool. You can stack up to 5 different alembics on top of a single furnace. The essentia can then be extracted out of an alembic using files. Yeah, but that doesn't say anything about this alchemical construct. That's not good. So we need 5 of these guys. I don't know that we have enough iron over here. That's 25 plus 50. Oh, we might have enough. And we have some gold down there, so does that take yeah, there's the jars that we were looking for. These are not the jars you are looking for. Awesome. Okay. Let's see. We need silverwood planks. Cool. And that makes 2 each. Awesome. get a little bang for our buck on those. So we need 5 at least, and that gets 2 each, so we need 3 of these guys. And we already had... There we go. Awesome! Doo-doo-doo! And that's gonna take, 4.5 this each. Oh, man. There we go. Because now we have to do the other combines. Oh, look, I'm still getting those aspects from the knowledge fragments I ate earlier. Okay, so we need our iron. And we're going to need buckets. We're going to need 5 buckets. Boom. Ooh, just barely enough in there. And boop, boop. What am I missing? Oh, another piece of gold. I knew that. I did. That's why I got it out of the chest and had it in my inventory the whole time. More water! Oh, man! Okay, we have enough, I think, to do all of this. 5 alembics. And we still have... Oh, you can't... you can't double tap those to get them out. Ooh, that was a lot of iron. Okay, so... Now we need to find a place... Our sapling isn't growing. We need to find a place to break these guys down. What do you say? Right there. Oh, I think you still need a crucible under here. So let's go ahead and grab some more iron. Oh, I am running low. We have 13,000 iron. I currently do not have any iron incoming, so I don't have the sifters going. I haven't set anything up yet. I was gonna do the mining laser, but I've got sucked into the bees. Yeah, I think we're gonna need another crucible to put under there. I don't think it needs a heat source for it. I'm not sure. I think we need one of these. Or am I thinking something else? I think I'm thinking something else. I think that's for the alchemical construct that I'm thinking. I don't think these need a crucible at all. Bloop. Oh, this is going to be hard. Oh, there's no interface, so no need to shift. Awesome. All right, now we can break things down. And things will get blown up into here. We just need some, like, coal or charcoal to put into there. Break things down. Get things put into jars. And then we can use the infusion altar. And we're probably going to go ahead and call it here. Woot! But first, I have prepared... I feel so horrible about eating this banana nut bread, because I didn't have any veggies or a good solid meal, so I wanted to make up for that and just have a good meal. So I prepared stuff to make roast chicken. Oh yeah, so let's get some of this stuff, because it looks really good. My mouth has been watering for some roast chicken this whole time. Yes! And we're just gonna... I feel so horrible about eating that. So we're gonna gonna just get our roast chicken. And of course, I'm full of banana nut bread and I can't eat my supper. So, yeah, this is what we're gonna be eating now. At least today. This episode or next episode. I think I'll have some different kind of food. I really, there are tons and tons of recipes in Pam's mod. I really think it's just a waste to eat one type of food because it's the best when there's Sunday roast. I mean, Sunday roast. How do you... Oh wait, that's just the roast chicken. This isn't the Sunday roast. Ugh. So, I made 64 of the wrong thing. But that's okay. It was going to make 64 of those anyway. Oh yeah, because this is roast chicken. And now they're going to add spinach and roast potatoes. Oh yeah. Gonna get my veggies on. Yes. Let's run around so we can eat something. Let's run around. I want to eat some roast chicken. I want to eat some roast chicken. I had too much sugar and I want to eat some roast chicken. Now give me some food. I don't think I'm running fast enough. I don't know if it goes, if your hunger goes down while you're flying. Does it? Does it? We're not sure. I'm sprinting. I can see that little bar moving. Look, we have hunger. We have hunger. Roast. Sunday roast. Ah, oh, yeah. Yeah, like I was saying, there are so many cool meals that you can make with Pam's mods that it seems just a waste to only eat one thing. So, I'm going to try and eat different things and say thank you, Pam, for all the delicious recipes in your mod. We love them. They're delicious. They're delicious. We might need a little refuel up here for our jetpack as well. So, we're just refueling everything. Anyway, I'm probably going to try and get some different aspects broken down for our Thaumcraft so we can maybe do an infusion or two next time. Because there's this super cool... Look, we did a quest. A quest? I didn't even know. So that's for distal. They're so packed together, it's hard to see them. Arcane Alembic, that's what we had. An Arcane Alembic is placed on top of an alchemical furnace to collect the essentia. You can stack up to 5 on one furnace. Oh, yeah. Awesome. And we need, we'll make. I'll probably go ahead and have this one done because we'll need glass vials to transfer all of the aspects into the warded jars. Unless I can figure out, remember how to automate that and it will go into the jars itself. I don't know. It's been so long. So I might have this quest done by next time. Since it is files, it's so easy. But I was really wanting to do this scholar's lens so I could not have the thermometer on my hotbar, you know. I mean, it's cool, but sometimes it's a little bit hard to have everything on your hotbar all at once. So, yeah. Oh, anyway, I'm going to let you go, and we'll see you next time. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye. Bye-bye.